Berks Community Action Program on BCTV is supported by the Berks Community Action Program.
Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to the Berks Community Action Program on BCTV. My name is Jodi Redinger. I'm BCAP's Community Relations Coordinator. We are live today, Tuesday, July 3rd, in the BCTV studios. As we move through 2018, we're now in the second half of 2018. I'm jumping back to what we kind of started at the beginning of the year and talking to positive people in our community who are making change. It's one of the best parts of my job as I get out and about in the community is to meet so many people that are invested in our community and invested in changing our community. So today I am so thrilled to have the co-leader of Students Demand Action, Talia Spillerman, with me today. We're going to talk a little bit about what Students Demand Action is, what they're doing in our community, and of course how you guys can reach out and help. And I also have BCAP's Promoting Responsible Fatherhood, Yes, Mentor Coordinator, Stephan Fains with us as our parental perspective today. He's got some kids in the high school and can help on what parents can do and what's important with that. So without further ado, Talia and Stephan, thank you very much for joining me today.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, you're so welcome. Talia, we were talking a little bit before we got started because I had met your other co-leader at an event and was very excited about what Students Demand Action does and what it can bring to our community. And I, of course, said, oh, wow, this is a great youth group that I can get involved with. They'll do all the work and I can just come and support it. So I always like to make my job a little bit easier. So if you want to start by telling me a little bit about what Students Demand Action is and kind of how you got involved.
So Students Demand Action is a gun violence prevention group. We just, you know, want to prevent gun violence. It's part of a bigger movement called Every Towns, and they help give us information about what bills we want to lobby for and what we can do to prevent gun violence. Right now, one of our really big goals is voter registration. We want to register as many people to vote as possible, because if you don't vote to make a change, nothing's going to happen.
Right, and we were talking about that before, that every vote counts. And I think somebody's trying to give me a hint, because I've had a lot of people talking to me about voter registration in the last week. And it's always something that we've made available at BCAP and talked about with BCAP and promoted at all of our events. But maybe we need to even talk, you know, more and more about that, because every vote counts. Voter registration is incredibly important. And you told me earlier that Students Demand Action is also, it's a national movement. You guys are focusing on voter registration right now, but there's also some partner groups like Mothers Demand Action or Moms Demand Action?
Yeah, there's Moms Demand Action, which is like Students Demand Action, just moms.
Okay. And what motivated you to get involved with this?
I think the recent events of how common school shootings are, I feel like that shouldn't happen. I think school should be a place of safety, and I want to do whatever I can to help make it that change.
And that's very commendable. And it's sad. As I see the news, it scares me what students have to go up against. You know, you're not just worrying about your biology test or your chemistry test. You have to worry about, you know, is that backpack have something in it? It shouldn't. And that's really scary. So I definitely commend you. Stephan, we got you here as a parent perspective. Where do you stand with this as a parent?
It's scary. I mean, what's going on with these kids? But the one good thing I could say is the kids are going to be the ones to change it. I mean, even when you've seen the shootings that happened in the other school, it was the kids who are coming to these lobbyists, because kids, They don't care about politics. They don't care. To them, shooting people is wrong. Let's fix it. So that's why I think it's working with the younger kids doing it, because a lot of these parents, these lobbyists, you go home to a young kid, and when your kid is telling you, no, this is wrong, people are dying, it's to me, it's like the only way the grown-ups can separate themselves from the politics to the kids is when it's coming from the kids, you know? And I think the kids are doing an amazing job, because, like she said, she's years away from voting. She's fighting for voting rights. Like, it's how America started. It's what America's all about, standing up and speaking out. And I mean, if kids are going to be the ones to save us all, then let's get behind them and help them, because the grown-ups are doing a terrible job at the moment. So, I mean, I'm behind the kids 100%.
And that's great. And what you told me before about Students Demand Action that I thought was really great is it's not just one high school. It's several high schools across the county. So it's definitely an effort. It's not us against them. And the young lady, your co-leader, is from Reading High, and that's how I met her at an event that they were part of. But I think it's great that it's Reading High, it's Wilson, and there's other schools involved. And you've also got some advisors, some adult advisors. You've been meeting at the Jewish Federation. BCAP is here to help you as much as we can. With our funding, we can't do things like tell people how to vote. But we certainly commend the efforts of what the youth do. And I know the Moms Demand Action had an event this spring over at Reading Public Museum, and I know Senator Schwenk was there and several other legislators. So you guys are really capturing the attention. And like Stephan said, I think definitely the students coming out and doing this and saying, wait a minute, this is wrong. Let's do something about it. So how did Students Demand Action end up coming to Reading or to Berks County?
Well, first there was the Moms Demand Action Group, and they helped bring Students Demand Action, and they found an advisor for us. And right now we're just getting the student group together, figuring out our goals for our own community.
So is your mom part of Moms Demand Action?
Not yet.
I was curious as to what came first, whether you're pulling her in or she's pulling you in. That's great. And you know, sometimes it's dangerous for me to talk to people because I get enthusiastic about their causes also. But this is a great thing for the city and for the county. I think it's wonderful. About how many students are active in your group right now?
Right now, I want to say we have somewhere between 10 and 15.
Okay. And that's a small enough group that they can certainly change.
And we're growing. We would love to have more members.
Okay. Are you reaching out at this point on social media, or you're still trying to get everything underneath of you and go from there?
Yeah, we do have some social media accounts, and we're trying to, you know, figure out, you know, friends. And obviously, I think once school starts, we'll be able to get the word out more. But
I think it's so much easier to do things like you're doing now than it was when I was in high school, because we had to rely on things like phone trees and, you know, mimeograph sheets, and we didn't have social media to blast it out to everybody. We did have BCTV back then, but we didn't have a lot of other stuff. So that's great. So we were talking about March for Our Lives, which is a group that Students Demand Partnership is. And refresh my memory. Did they start you guys, or you're working together?
We work together, but they're two different groups. Okay. March for Our Lives came out after the Parkland shooting, and right now they're doing a tour around the U.S. and around Florida to for voter registration as well. They have different, you know, events and rallies, and there's a lot of voter registration there too.
Okay, so this is all getting a lot of press. You know, our message today that we definitely want to say again and again and again is your vote counts, and you can't vote unless you register. And even somebody who's not old enough yet can tell us that. And it's very important, and it's very important to stress to our students that are going to be voting for the next 50, 60, 70 years, that you need to start now, and you can make a change. I know our local legislators are always extremely receptive to talking to constituents. I have a lot of contact with all of them. And sometimes Representative Caltagirone in the elevator or the hallway, because his office is in the same building as ours. But definitely, you know, reaching out to them is so important. Now, you were telling me that as a national group, Students Demand Action gives you all kinds of resources and things like that. So if you wanted to do a voter registration drive, all you would have to do is contact them.
Yeah, and they would actually send us materials, you know, information, and like how to do it, and like, because not only do we want people to register to vote, but we want them to understand how to vote in a smart way. So we would give them information about which candidates are supported by the NRA and which ones are not.
Okay.
Every town's the big group that Moms Demand Action and Students Demand Action are under. They give candidates a certain distinction. I want to say it's called like a smart gun sense distinction.
Okay.
And they're Democrats and Republicans who they take a kind of like a survey, and they give them this distinction that shows that they are, you know, have good gun sense.
Mm. Wow. Okay, it sounds like a lot of work and a lot to learn. I know I was very impressed when I met Janice at how much she knew about the different bills that were before the Senate and the House and different things that were going on. And I try to do some of that for my job, and I don't always succeed. But definitely it's a lot to learn and a lot to know. So at this point, we've talked about, you know, you're forming at this point, so we can expect to see lots of great things from Student Demand Action once they get back to school. Everybody's on vacation right now, kind of laid back. But in September, looking to get some more schools involved, and you said you're trying to get your goals formulated. Do you have any goals at this point for the 2018-2019 school year?
So far, I know that we really wanted to do voter registration, as I talked about before.
Okay.
And yeah, we really have to talk and see what else we would like to do. Like, could be lobbying, you know, hosting rallies.
Does Students Demand Action give you any information on, obviously changing the laws is so important, but how to prevent the school shootings, what to look for in your fellow students? Ways to help with that? No. Okay.
I'm not sure. I really haven't been able to access all the information yet.
Okay. I'm sorry to put you on the spot. But that may definitely be a way that some of our community can reach out and do that. I know Stephan and I have done a training called Mental Health First Aid, which helps you, you know, if somebody's in crisis, helps you recognize that and take steps to get them the help they need. And I think, you know, that's an important part of this too. You know, we can try to change the legislators' minds, we can try to pass laws, but also, you know, recognizing our fellow students that are in need and reaching out to them and making that positive. Okay. So we talked a little bit about how you can register to vote. And believe me, next week we will have voter registration cards at BCAP, both entrances. But you also said you can do it online.
Yep.
And Pennsylvania has passed a law that you can do it when you renew your driver's license? Motor voter?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah. So, and you need to change your address when you move, which you can do online. You need to change your address if you get married. But the most important thing is we need to get out and vote. We have elections coming up in November. It's a midterm election, so it's not a big presidential election, but we still have some very important races.
It's still important.
It's always important. And we were talking about how much individual votes count. And I was sharing that as a machine operator in Spring Township in the presidential election, our presidential race was incredibly close in our precinct by just a couple votes. So if a couple more people had voted in each precinct, it could have changed not only Pennsylvania's response, but the entire nation's response. So if everybody says, oh, we'll let somebody else do it, then nobody ends up doing it.
Exactly.
So voter registration is really important. And hopefully we'll be able to bring that to the schools. I know there's a group that I met with yesterday called Next Gen America and Next Gen Pennsylvania that they're also working on the same thing. Their demographic's a little bit older, too. They're looking at 18 to 35-year-olds, where obviously in the school district you're not going to have more than 18 or 19-year-olds. But hopefully you can pressure some of your teachers, too, and make sure that they are registered to vote. Okay, so you got a mom's demand action, you got a student's demand action. We got our fatherhood coordinator. Where's our dad's demand action?
I know, I was sitting here thinking, like, maybe we should do something like that. And I mean, I should. I mean, we're talking about gun violence, stuff like that. I've been affected by that stuff since I was, like, 14. You know what I mean? I've been losing friends to guns for a long time, you know? So that's why I always march against this stuff. And I mean, I'm okay with everybody having their guns for your real reasons, but we got to do something. You know what I mean? Kids are losing their lives, and at school, at church, it's like nowhere safe anymore. So we definitely got to do anything we can to change even the smallest laws. And it all starts with voting. It all starts with putting the right people in place and things like that. So I'm willing to help and do whatever we can do.
Oh, no, I really put you on the spot, too, huh?
Yeah, no, I'm definitely all for that, because I think the biggest problem with the gun issue, there's a lot of hypothetical situations that are, it's meaning more than actual situations. Like, there are kids actually dying right now, but the argument becomes, well, what if somebody breaks in your house and, okay, that might happen. This is happening. Schools are getting shot. We have to change something about the laws, the rules, who can get a gun, how you can get a gun. I mean, people are losing their lives, and that's the most important thing we all have, is our life, you know? So, dad's against, I'm willing to start it and do something about it.
And it's scary, too. I mean, I know at my age, it's heartbreaking when I lose a friend or I lose. But at the beginning of your life, you know, 15, 16, 17, to have your classmates just shot down next to you and to see that kind of stuff is so incredibly scary. So I think this is so important that you guys are starting in the high schools and starting and saying, you know, we don't want this to happen in our schools anymore. We want our schools to be a safe place, you know, and we're not going to... We're not going to stand at the door with guns to do it. Right. We're going to use our voices. We're going to use the other tools that are available to us to do it. Oh, that's great. This is so exciting. And definitely such a positive movement that's going on that's going to, I'm sure, is going to start small. And you guys are going to just snowball and get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. So, Talia, what kind of event would you like to do at Wilson High School? You know, you want to do some voter registration, but how would you let your fellow students know how important this is?
How important it is to vote?
To vote and to know what the laws are and to tell your legislators, you know, we don't want this. You know, we want laws passed that protect us.
I think people need to understand the importance of voting, too, like you said earlier. Like, people, they need to understand what they can do to make a difference. Because I think a lot of people, they know, like, oh, this isn't right, but they don't know what to do to help make a difference. And I think I can help, and, you know, Students Demand Action can help by informing people, you know, what they can do to make a difference.
So do you think if you and your fellow students learn about the laws and start this action that you're going to pull your parents in and make them responsible and say, you know, now, you know, mom and dad, you need to do this too. Do you think we can snowball that way? Because a lot of what we hear about voting is, oh, you know, I don't know who to vote for. I don't know how to vote. And I know Election Services has been doing a lot. They have a mobile voting machine that they take out and they try to show people, because as a machine operator, you know, I have people going, I don't know what to do. And I have to stand outside the curtain because I can't go in with them and say, you know, you have this list of candidates here and you have this list of candidates here. But we're seeing people that don't know how to vote, that the whole process is scary. Mm-hmm. So I think, you know, encouraging people to register to vote is great, but also demystifying the whole process.
Yeah.
You know, making sure. And one of the positive things that I see is so many parents coming and bringing their kids in with them. And, you know, now.
Yeah, my parents have done that.
Right. And my mom did it too, and I remember the lady at the nasty lady at the polls when I was about 7. You can't take her in there. I don't say that.
No.
We definitely. What we do say is, don't let your kid press that red button at the bottom because that that means you can't do any other changes. That solidifies your vote. But I can definitely see your movement not only affecting the students but also their parents. Because in our community, especially more in Reading, we have a lot of immigrant parents and people who are not from this area. That, you know, they may not be comfortable in English. They may not be comfortable with the whole process. But to get for their children to be comfortable and say, hey, Mom, Dad, this isn't that bad. Mm-hmm. And we see a lot of that, too. We see parents bringing their kids the first time to vote and stuff like that. So, all right. We got a lot working here.
I know,
guys. all right, your vote counts, March for Our Lives. Students demand action. We got high school students across the county that are speaking up, speaking out, letting their voices be heard. Talia Spillerman's here. She's one of the co-leaders of the group. Very articulate young lady. She's told us a little bit about what Students Demand Action is. It's part of a nationwide group. There's a Mothers Demand Action part of it. Maybe there'll be like an old Social Workers Demand Action part of it that forms at some point. But it's not something that the students should be doing alone. It's not something that the mothers should be doing alone. It's something that each and every one of us in the community should be a part of. And we don't want there to be a tragedy in our community or a tragedy close by that's what's spurring us to action. You know, there's too many scary things going on for our students in their high schools, and that shouldn't be happening. There's too many scary things going on in the middle schools and the elementary schools, too. So we need to continue to address these issues with our legislators. We need to continue to encourage our students to say, you know, we're the future. We are the ones that are coming up after you. We're the voices. So definitely we need to pass these laws. We need to make sure that we are made safe, that our children are going to be safe, and that when y'all retire and we're paying your Social Security, you're going to be safe too.
I think that's the great thing about what they're doing. I mean, they're not waiting until somebody they know gets shot. They're not waiting until it affects them personally. They're like, no, it's just wrong. Let's just fix it before it gets to my school. And that's the way it should be. And I mean, if we're at a point where now the kids are teaching the grown-ups, then that's where we got to be. I mean, because they're way ahead of the curve. It's handle the problem before it touches you, because by the time it gets to you, it's too late already.
That's it.
So I mean, that's why voting, getting out and knowing you're voting 2 years early, and that's huge. That's important. You know what I mean? That's how you make change. You start young and then you're already into it. So they're doing a wonderful job. And they're in Wilson, so where I'm at. So I'm definitely do whatever I can to help. My kids go to Wilson too. So I'm definitely willing to help out any way possible.
And Wilson is such a big school. I mean, I come from Mount Penn, a very small school. And I remember my husband tells the story from Twin Valley of actually there being fields in back of the high school and taking his shotgun to school with him to shoot things at lunchtime, you know, and bring meat home for the family. That doesn't fly anymore.
Yeah.
Shows the redneck that I married into. But times have definitely changed, and guns are a scary kind of thing. So we definitely applaud the efforts of the students that are coming forward and the parents that are saying, hey, you know, we're behind our kids. We want them to have a positive experience in school.
Right now, we're basically saying the current system is not working and we need to make a change.
That's it. The current system is not working and we need to make a change.
I mean, look at the news. Like,
that's in bare bones. That's the simplest thing. You know, if it's broke, fix it.
Right.
Yep.
You know, if it's hanging by a thread, let's sew it up. Let's do what we can to make things better. And I love that this is happening before a tragedy comes to Berks County. We've had too many to begin with. We have enough shootings outside of the schools around here, enough kids getting hurt. So we definitely want to reach out and make sure. This is so exciting. And there's so many opportunities for you guys to come together and do this. And getting the other schools involved is great. And I really look forward to seeing what's happening when the schools go back. I certainly hope.
Yeah, the more people involved, the better. And we've been getting great community support.
That's wonderful. And I know our local legislators have been behind this also, because I've seen Senator Schwenk and Representative Rossi, Representative Cal DeJerome. So definitely getting them involved, and you know, letting your faces be known. You know, every local legislator has an office. You know, let them know who you are. Invite them to your events. If they don't come, they'll usually send a staff. Mm-hmm. We've had great success with inviting people to our events and things like that. And, you know, put your parents to work, too. let them get the word out and, you know, this is going on and this is happening and talking about it and saying enough is enough. We definitely want to stop what's going on. So we've got students home on summer vacation that have been anxiously watching this program and want to be a part of Students Demand Action. How do they do that?
You can visit our Instagram page. We have our, and you can contact us from there.
Okay.
Or you can, that's actually a really good question.
Well, is there a sign up off of the national page or not?
Yes, actually, yeah. You can go to Students Demand Action and you can sign up nationally and they will direct you to the local chapter.
Oh, fantastic. Okay. So we were just about at the end of the program and we've talked about so much. So, all right, Stephan, quickly, sum us up. Encourage other parents.
Get out and vote. And I mean, if your kids are out there trying to do things, then you need to follow in your kids' footsteps. I mean, it's up to all of us. We all live in this community, you know, like even with myself, a lot of times people ask me, how come you're always in Reading? Your kids don't go to Reading. Yeah, but Reading problems can spill over to where we're at, just like any other problem. So we got to all take care of our community, the grown-ups, the kids, everybody together. And
oh, and I know from doing so much in the community, I meet so many incredible people, whether they be 15, 50, 75, you know, sometimes even younger, that it's so neat to be a part of the community and to be out there. And if I would just stay in my, you know, little suburban, you know, enclave down in Birdsboro, I wouldn't get to meet all those people. I wouldn't know anything about Students Demand Action. Yeah. So definitely get out, get involved. It doesn't have to be, you know, your community. Reach out. The best thing we can do is to let our neighbors know we care. All right, Talia, what do we need to know?
The more people involved, the better. If this is something that you are passionate about or you know anyone who else is passionate about, visit SDA.org and sign up.
And that's it. You know, this is the Berks Community Action Program. We've got our Positive People series in 2018. This is July. We have Talia Spillerman. I don't know why I want to keep on changing your last name. Talia Spillerman here, who's one of the co-leaders of Students Demand Action. Stephan Fains, who's our fatherhood coordinator and Yes Mentor coordinator. We're talking about Students Demand Action, Get the Vote Out America, encouraging people to vote and to let it be known what you're interested in and what we need to do in our community. So as we wrap up, I'd like to thank Stephan and Talia for joining me today, BCAP for having us, and for everyone at BCAP, where we believe, come on guys, a neighbor in need is
a call to action.
Thank you. Have a good day.
Berks Community Action Program on BCTV is supported by the Berks Community Action Program.